Hey everyone, welcome to Three Guys, One Movie. I'm Angus. Me and Zach just saw Hurricane Heist. Mitch hasn't seen it, but he's seen the trailer. So Mitch, I want you to explain what you think Hurricane Heist's about.
Well, I'm not too sure if the hurricane is committing a heist, or if the heist takes place during a hurricane, but it seems like there's something to do with a hurricane and a heist.
I
think the hurricane was in on it, because it shows up right as they're robbing a bank.
They're like, let's use this hurricane.
No, the hurricane was like, I'm going to use these people and blow all the money away.
It had a face. It had a vendetta.
Yeah, okay, that's the biggest thing. Yeah.
It had a face?
It had a fucking face.
It had a skull face.
No fucking way.
Right at the beginning, I wasn't expecting it to get that dumb right away.
Me too.
I was hoping, but first of all, the movie begins. Picture this in your head. There's a scene of two little boys in the house that are scared, and their dad runs out to their truck, and he's like hooking up a hook to it so that it'll stay still. And then just out of nowhere, this big wrecking ball tumbles over, flattens their dad in front of them. And it's hilarious the angle it's shot from. And then the two little kids, their house gets picked up like an up, and I actually thought it was going to float away for a second. And then the roof comes off, and they look up, and the cloud above them turns into a big fucking skull and roars at them like a lion.
And
then it cuts to the title.
Hurricane Heist.
It's incredible.
That was one of the very few times when I've actually verbally said something out loud.
We both went,
fear. I'm like, what the fuck?
We were like the only two people, too. There was two people, like, way behind us, and they were also killing themselves laughing.
Yeah.
The movie just, it's so bad, but this is gonna be, like, the so bad it's good movie of the year to beat. Because I was totally entertained by this thing. Like, it's
dumb.
From a directing standpoint, from an acting standpoint, from a writing standpoint, it's bad.
Yeah.
It's
but
well made.
Does it?
But it's hilarious.
Does it know it's bad?
Yes.
I think
parts of it know
but
it's
see,
bad.
But that's the thing, yeah. That's kind of the beauty of it, because it's the same director as...
Triple X and Fast and the Furious. It's Rob Cohen.
There's parts where it genuinely feels like, man, like, they know, like, it feels like they're in on it. Like, oh, it's kind of goofy and lighthearted, but you can sort of tell that he's, like, trying to make, like, a cool action movie. It's like, oh, man, bring your butts to this movie, man. It's going to be good fun. So it's like, no, it's just...
It's not like a Sharknado where it's intentionally bad.
It's not that bad.
No, it's not like that. It's not like an Asylum movie. That's the weird thing. This thing had a $35 million budget.
Mm-hmm.
So he actually managed to convince these guys to give him money. Like, and I think it's Universal or something that produced it, wasn't it?
I can't remember.
It's a big studio that produced it.
It's
2018
and we're spending money on this shit.
Yeah. But here... I just want to know how the pitch meeting went down. That's my thing. Because I hope, like, Rob Cohen just, like, called the agency and was like, guys, I got an idea for another Fast and Furious. And they're like, Rob, you can't do that. Fast and Furious is owned by someone else now. And he's like, but I want to do it. And they're like, you can't do that. And he's like, okay, what if I put it in a hurricane? And then they were like, you know what? That's going to make a shit ton of money. Cut to the actual box office number and the thing fucking tanked.
Oh, I don't doubt it.
And like, I just want to know how high he was. Because, like, he must have been on coke the whole time they were filming. And he was like, oh, shoot the sky right now, we'll turn it into a skull.
Oh, man.
And also, we haven't even touched on the fact that hubcaps are used as a weapon at one point in the film.
That was fucking
hilarious. That was kind of incredible. And I actually weirdly predicted that scene was going to happen. Because there's a scene where a car flips over and the two hubcaps fly off of it and fly away. And I leaned over to Zach and went, no way, they're not going to start throwing hubcaps, are they? And then some guy grabs a bag of hubcaps and starts throwing them up into the wind and they're... firing past them, and it sounds like bullets. It's going like every time, and then some dude gets fucking impaled with one.
Oh my!
And then like I love that too, because like he gets impaled, and the guy's reaction is like, ah, jeez. Like,
it's the most indifferent reaction to a friend dying. Shit! Just like,
oh well, I mean,
we got to talk about the dialogue in general, because there was that. There was a couple setup lines at the beginning with, like, people joking back and forth that were really awkward. And then there was the scene when they had the girl, and they're threatening her. And the one guy in a really deep southern accent just goes, we're gonna cattle prod your private.
What the fuck? It's, like, brutal. It's, like, it was just, like, holy fuck.
Also, this movie broke the peeing and talking rule. There was a scene where two characters are peeing, and I'm also not sure why that's even in the movie. But they actually showed characters stop to pee, because that's the number one complaint with all the Fast and Furious movies. No one ever stops to pee.
No one stops.
So Rob
was
like,
actually a complaint?
Rob Cohen was like, I'm gonna show them stop, and they're gonna take a pee, and they're gonna break urinal etiquette, and they're gonna talk to each other while they're peeing.
See, that's the thing. They weren't smart enough. They didn't bring a pee bottle.
Well, if they know each other, they're
guys, Fast and Furious don't know how to do that.
They talking to each other at the urinal is really that weird.
It kind of is. And it's a girl and a guy. So she's, like, crouched over in the corner, and they're just talking.
Well, the girl in the urinal is...
They're like, planning about what to do while they're peeing. And then, also, the scene that follows this up is the two of them run into a mall that I guess has, like, a vacuum in it somehow because it's, like, closed in with a glass roof. And they have this big diversion plan that they're going to get the guy's brother back that they have hostage or whatever because these bank robbers are taking a bunch of people hostage. And he comes up with this brilliant idea that if they shoot through the glass, break it, it's going to suck everyone out like a fucking tornado. Yeah. And it actually does. And the best part is, the two of them are attached to harnesses and go flying up out the roof too. But because they're attached to the harnesses, they're just waving in the wind like a wacky waving inflatable arm men. Just fucking waving around. It's the most ridiculous looking fucking thing.
Okay.
Oh, man.
Do you recommend this movie?
Yes.
I wouldn't pay money to go see it.
No, but I think if this comes to Netflix or something, we did.
You did. That's
the things we do to make stupid reviews. But, like, it's one of those movies where I feel like if it comes to Netflix or whatever, I'd throw it on with a couple drunk friends. Because this is one of those movies that's like... And I almost feel like even us explaining it, you kind of have to see it to believe it. Because the skull monster thing is incredible. And it happens more than once. It happens at the end of the movie, too. When it's almost going to eat their truck. It's like coming up behind them like Pac-Man.
Yeah.
No way.
Oh, man. It's bad, but it's like good bad.
Weird PG-13 sex scene, too. When the two couple are in the truck and she's just kind of like moving like this on top of them. They're like having... Like he's... The guy's driving and his girlfriend and him are like kind of having... Getting sassy and frisky. And then it cuts to a weird shot of them... What looks... Appears to be them trying to have sex. But she's just kind of like...
I also
wiggling around a bit.
I have to point out before we do ratings. I have to point out the fact that this movie ends on the most abrupt note I've seen in any movie in a long time. Because they escape this hurricane. They're still in the hurricane though, right? They're in the eye of the hurricane, so they're in the middle of it. So they have to keep driving at the same speed as the hurricane, otherwise they'll get sucked into it, right? And you never get any closure on that. They're just they get into the eye of it, and they're like, "Oh man, yeah, all the bad guys got sucked up there." And then the movie literally just like shows the sunset, and then credits roll over the sunset.
Yeah.
And there's no clarification on anything that happens to anyone.
Who's in this film?
The guy from The Witch. He's got the really deep...
Oh, yeah, voice. That is him. Toby Kebbell's in it. And he can't do an American accent.
Is the guy
for
from
shit.
True Blood in it, too? Is that one of the players?
Well, Maggie Grace is in it. The one from Taken. The one who played his daughter.
Oh, okay. Was that the
she was
lady?
The female cop.
Oh, okay.
That's too bad, because she was good in Lost.
Yeah, no, she was in that show, yeah, I guess,
washed up.
She drives a fire. Sorry to kind of backtrack a bit, but opening bit when they're stuck in traffic because everybody's evacuating
in
town.
And she just straight up drives
the truck off.
She's a fucking cop, and they're in traffic, and she not only does she drive off into traffic, but she floors it into the car in front of her to push
them
out of the way.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
And then just drives
backs
off through someone's cornfield. And it's like, you're law enforcement.
Yeah.
Not a way law enforcement
that should never come up again,
especially not in 2018 when people hate cops. Not a good portrayal of cops.
That kind
of
stuff never comes up, though.
No, it's
badass,
man.
You're just a bitch. It's like, wait in traffic like everybody else.
Also made me like
Southern badass cop.
Oh, man, this movie's terrible. I guess, let's do numbers. What are you thinking?
Four or five. It wasn't good, but it
Whoa,
is.
Well, that's a five.
Really
is, five is a big number for this movie.
Yeah.
Like I was never mad. It's not like like it's bad, but it's not like
it's
you watch and you're like, what the fuck? You're pissed off. It was.
Yeah.
You can definitely watch this. Like, okay, if it goes on Netflix, don't pay for this movie at all. Please don't get this movie your money.
Don't do what we did.
But if it comes on Netflix or other ways of doing it, you can. Yeah, just fucking sit down with a couple friends, have beers or whatever, and just laugh at it.
It's a fun watch. That's the thing. I'm about the same as you. I was gonna say 4.5. Even though, like, in terms of quality, this movie should be at like a 2 or a 3.
Yeah,
because it's a lot worse. But because it was entertaining enough, and I had enough fun with it, and I had the urge to fucking make a video about it. Like, this movie is dumb enough that I want to tell people about
it. Yeah, it's
and
the fact
I'm recommending
that
it for that reason.
Sat here and you told me about it, and I feel like I've watched it now. Like. I feel like I've seen this movie now that
you
described it. You
need to
so
see it to believe it.
I'm going to give it a 10 out of 10.
10 out of 10 for that trailer? top tier trailer editing?
Top tier trailer editing.
Alright, so I guess that's it for Hurricane Heist. If you guys have any more suggestions for dumbass disaster movies, we'll watch those. So leave those down in the description. Follow us all on Twitter, Letterboxd, all that. We'll have it down below. And catch you next time.
See ya.